thank you. This morning on today's update, imagine if you started to sneeze and you simply couldn't stop. Well, that's exactly what happened to 12-year-old Lauren Johnson. She was sneezing up to 12 times a minute. In November, Lauren shared her medical mystery with us, and she's back with an update. We're going to hear from her in just a moment. But first, NBC's chief medical editor, Dr. Nancy Snyderman, has her story.
It all began with a common cold at the end of October. Lauren Johnson was sneezing constantly.
It's been 2 weeks now, and it just hasn't stopped.
It was happening all day, every day, up to 12,000 times a day. The 12-year-old girl only stopped when she was able to sleep.
Nobody really knows how to treat it, what's going to work.
Her family consulted all kinds of physicians. They tried everything from therapy to hypnosis to allergy testing. The Johnsons shared their story here on Today.
It became a rhythmic, nonstop, chronic sneeze. That's when we first really became alarmed a few weeks ago.
After her appearance, people from around the world contacted the Johnsons, hoping to help.
Spasms of cough.
Including top child development experts who treat disorders like Tourette's syndrome and other neurological diseases.
I got an EEG, MRI, CT, and was an ear, nose, and throat doctor.
After an exhausting and sometimes confusing 6 weeks, they came back on Today in December to share with us the diagnosis. PANDAS.
Well, PANDAS is an acronym. It's a bunch of letters that stand for a bigger thing, pediatric autoimmune disorders associated with streptococcus. In this condition, what typically happens is following a strep infection, like a strep pharyngitis, a child will develop a sudden onset of either tics or OCD type behavior.
Because PANDAS is a newly recognized disease, treatment can be controversial. But Lauren Johnson and her family are finally on their way to having some answers.
And Dr. Nancy Snyderman is here along with Lauren Johnson, her mom Lynn, and her doctor Dennis Bobulis. Good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And notice the silence. Lauren, you're not sneezing anymore. That is great news.
Thank you.
How long ago did this stop?
About 2 weeks ago.
How are you feeling now?
A lot better.
A lot better. Lynn, 2 weeks ago, just stopped.
Well, it gradually stopped, but over a two-day period. But, yeah, she stopped.
And it stopped with the treatment. Dr. Bobulis,
yes.
As we mentioned, she was diagnosed with PANDAS.
Yes.
First of all, explain how this sort of kicked the sneezing, how that all of that started happening.
What we did was we treated her with the intravenous immune globulin.
IVIG.
IVIG, which is commonly called. And what you do with IVIG is you infuse antibodies, which serve to complex with the autoantibodies that are being generated by the immune system that go into the brain and cause the movement disorder. Mm-hmm. In Lauren's case, the sneezing tic.
Now explain what PANDAS really is and how it really started this whole tic to begin with.
Well, PANDAS is a condition that develops initially after an infection with group A strep.
Uh-huh.
And the immune system responds by making antibodies, creating cytokines, immune complexes that are generated from exotoxins from the strep,
right,
that cross the blood-brain barrier. The blood-brain barrier is breached, and it attacks a certain part of the brain called the basal ganglia.
Right.
And there are shifts in hormones in that part of the brain. Dopamine, for example, goes up or down, mm-hmm. Depending on which receptor is triggered, and that usually results in movement disorder, that results in obsessive-compulsive
right.
behavior.
And Nancy, this is a rarely new diagnosis.
It's new enough that when I was a pediatric resident, I didn't know anything about it. In fact, as
right.
cases have sort of hit the literature over the last couple of years, I've learned a lot. But I think the underlying theme you hear here is a bacterial infection
mm-hmm.
that triggers almost a hyper reaction in the body.
Exactly.
And then the body sort of turns on itself when your immune system sort of sees
tics
itself as foreign.
OCD.
Things like tics, go ahead and click in.
Trigger the infection.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what actually happens is there's molecular mimicry. There are proteins on the strep
right.
That generate an immune response, and these antibodies now mistakenly think that certain brain tissue is is actually strep.
Right. And so, Lynn, mm-hmm. I mean, the great news is your daughter now is cured of this.
She's not cured? No. Like I said, these children, I mean, that's the biggest problem with this disease. You know, parents live in fear because they can be re-exposed to a bacteria, including strep, and re-manifest mm-hmm. again. Some children go years, some children go months. Some children never re-manifest again. We need to learn more about it. We need more research.
So you want the awareness to be out there. That's why
Absolutely.
It's so important you're back on with us for mm-hmm. that. And doctor, I mean, the chances that she will have to undergo some kind of recurring treatment, is that likely to be the case?
It's a possibility. We're watching her very closely right now.
Right. But I think in the meantime, you say, wow, the IVIG was a great success.
Mm-hmm. Great success.
Look how great she is. And then you have to get back to a new normal
yeah.
and re-embrace that and say, okay, well, whatever I had, mm-hmm. you assume that's going to be a resolution, and then you get ready for the fact that there might be needed therapy.
And just real quickly, Lauren, how's it feel to just not have to worry about that for now and just be back to school and back to your routine?
It feels a lot better. I'm not back to school yet, actually.
Not back to school?
But soon, hopefully.
Soon. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, we wish you all the best. Good luck with everything.
Thank you.
All right. We'll continue to follow your story. Thank you.